Okay, so this is an old, old game, as you can tell from the title. It is from 2006. So this is something you would play on, like, your parents' old PC that you probably had to beg them to buy you. The game, not the PC, but, yeah. This is CSI Crime Scene Investigation, Three Dimensions of Murder. I have found this game deeply hidden in all of my other PC games that I'm surprised still works and reads on this very up-to-date laptop. Thank you for this little CD drive that Short Stuff got me. So we're just going to jump in. I've already done one crime scene already, I believe. Yes, pictures at an execution. I know how to read, I swear. But my current ranking is master. I did very well on it without having to ask for any hints for help. But I'm not going to tell you how long it took me. So best ranking is master. So the next one, first person shooter. So let's go ahead and start it up.
Guess what? We have another call. Welcome to the wonderful world of CSI. I'm still helping Grissom with the caseloads, and I need you to head out to the computer game trade show at the Sphere's Convention Center. We have another possible homicide. Nick Stokes will be your partner. You like Nick. Everybody does. But behind that easygoing, low-key charm of his, you'll find one of the best crime scene investigators anywhere.
Location added. Since we're already sitting here in the lab, let's go off to the game demo booth, which is the crime scene.
Hey, I'm Nick. You into video games? Hope you like the shooting ones, because that's what we've got here. Vic took three hits, two in the torso, one between the eyes. Also, it's uncommonly warm in here. Feels like around 90 degrees. Not normal for a showroom floor with electronics. So, let's see what we can learn.
Oh, you gotta keep all that shit cool. With the hot room and then all the like TVs and game systems and computers going. You need to keep the temperature cool, so the TVs, the games, and all that, PlayStations, Xbox, PCs don't get too hot, because they're already going to make enough heat as it is, which already fucks up the whole thing of the body corners being able to tell the time of death, because the body loses, I believe, 2 degrees in the first hour and then 1 degree every hour after. But I think they measure that through the temperature of the liver. I think that's how they do that. I could be wrong. It's been a very long time since I've watched any CSI. But I think that's how they do it. Oh, hello. We're going to go look at the body first.
I've heard of life imitating art, but this is taking it a little too far. Can't be a coincidence that our Vic's body was found in the same posture as the guy on the poster.
A little bit.
M4 assault rifle. You can do a lot of killing with this baby, but unless you're well trained with it, it's not exactly a good close range defensive weapon.
Oh, not really, no. Okay, we'll just grab it.
Here we have an empty mag and chamber, and no GSR, so this puppy hasn't barked in a while. Also, its barrel has been modified. It couldn't fire real bullets if it wanted to.
There's a fingerprint right here. Let's just gather that fingerprint.
Sweet. The blood pool under the victim is smudged, indicating the body was dragged to this spot, probably posed.
Probably, but it should take a picture of it.
This needs attention ASAP. Let's use the mobile analysis unit. I'm not a medical examiner, but this looks like a handgun shot at close range. You should check for gunshot residue to be sure, but I'll bet you already knew that. From now on, I'll put any GSR samples we recover in a place where we can both access it.
Yeah, because you can see the burn marks all around it. So that kind of actually does look like he was shot at point-blank range. Execution style.
Not the right tool for this.
Okay. This looked awkward. Really awkward doing that. Never be too thorough.
You know, I'll play just about any kind of video game, but I think I'll pass on this sucker. I see enough carnage on the job.
Oh, wait, hold on. I see.
Hey, you got gamer's eyes yourself. A stray bullet could have a lot to say to us about exactly what went down here.
We may be able to tell what kind of bullet it is. Maybe.
Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough.
Yeah, but why is it 82 degrees?
Funky characters. Kinda doubt you'd find these two walking around inside some ultraviolet game. Wonder how this t-shirt was ripped.
Probably a scuffle, a fight. Most likely. Grabbed him by the collar. Or at least the collar area.
Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough. Looks like a display case for weapons. Heavy-duty weapons. I bet these are all used in the game somehow.
Fingerprint. Now that we got that going for us.
45 automatic. This could be our murder weapon. Someone could have shot our Vic, then placed the gun back in the display.
Could have, could have. I'm surprised they don't want me testing for GSR. I think now we could talk to her.
I have no idea. All I can say is Stan was like this when I found him. All shot up, bloody, horrible.
Do you know the victim?
Know him? Yeah, he's my boss.
Oh.
Was my boss. That's Stan Everston, the executive producer of our company, LZP. We're a gaming company, as you probably figured out. This is a demo room for the trade show attendees. We're showing our new game, Gut Wrench 3.
And what do you do for the company? Actually, you know what? I'm going to pause this real quick. This is going to ruin the screen, so I'm sorry. Pretty sure there's nothing important that happens up here. Pretty sure, but don't take my word on it. And what do you do for the company?
Marketing director is the title. But the truth is, I'm kind of a jack of all trades. I put it all together, from packaging input to rolling this out to retailers and the public. You wear a lot of hats in the gaming industry.
I know it's an obvious question, but I'm still going to ask, what is this booth set up for?
We're here to showcase Gut Wrench 3. You come to these trade shows hoping to generate some major buzz in the gaming press. A game is a product. Like a candy bar you want to convince customers to take a bite out of. Actually, it's more than that. You want them to crave that candy, right? So we're showing retailers what we've come up with in a setting where they can get lost in the game. I spent 6 months on the pre-hype, and with a top-selling, established game franchise, hey, the next Gut Wrench is the most anticipated title in years.
Okay, so then what's the game about?
Gut Wrench 3 is going to change the face of first-person shooters forever. The new dynamic incapacitation system and improved spatter physics has taken this franchise to a level of realism that was impossible when Gut Wrench 1 launched. We're the best first-person shooter on the market.
Has the game been released to the public yet?
No, we're a few weeks away. Truth is, we already have commitments from most of the retailers here. Our primary goal now is to generate buzz, to encourage buyers to up their orders. Trouble is, we still have critical bugs to fix. And with Stan gone, who knows if we'll make the launch date.
Okay, so why is it so hot in here, though?
I have no idea. It's not supposed to be this hot. Maybe somebody played with our AC setting.
Okay, so when's the last time you saw it in the life?
Well, last night. We set the booth up together. Or anyway, until I got burned out and was past the point of productivity. I bailed around 10:30.
And where'd you go afterwards?
I should have gone back to my hotel and into the jacuzzi and then bed. But hey, one of the perks of doing a trade show in Vegas is Vegas, right? Lots of big parties hosted by the game companies. By the time I got back to the hotel, oh God, it must have been way after midnight. Maybe, let me think, 2:15?
So was there anyone else here when you left?
Sure. Andy Penmore, the lead programmer.
Did you notice anything unusual when you left?
Well, the video game industry is inherently unusual. So that's a tougher one than it sounds. The ego, the testosterone in this little demo chamber. Could have sliced it and sold it for bacon. Stan didn't like to argue with Andy. Andy's too smart, got a wit and edge that'll cut you. Which is why Stan takes it out on me, usually. I mean, took it out on me.
Do you know where the programmer is?
Maybe in the room he and Stan are sharing? They were sharing. Damn, this is gonna be hard to get used to. Stan is, like, really gone, isn't he? Gonna take some time to process that. But yeah, you should try his hotel room.
Okay, so then, now that I can get to it, whose shirt is this?
It's not one of ours. Our ex-designer was wearing a shirt like that yesterday.
How'd it get ripped?
Hey, I don't do wardrobe. I'm marketing. No idea.
I thought you said you wore multiple hats in this job industry. What's the ex-designer's name?
Craig Landers. Used to work with us. Brilliant guy. He created the Fuzzy and Bill franchise for LZP. He's a little odd, but it's not really unusual for those creative types. You don't get into this business because you're normal.
And why is Craig no longer employed with LZP?
Honestly, I have no idea. He left before I was hired.
Okay, well, do you know where Craig is now?
No clue. If I had to guess, I'd say he's probably down on the show floor, trying to score free t-shirts or pictures with the booth babes.
Can we take your fingerprints?
Sure. I know that'll help rule me out as a suspect.
We'd like to do a gunshot residue test as well. It's standard in all gun-related investigations.
Sure.
Okay. Now we got gunshot residue test and fingerprint tests. So then we got that. I think we should probably go to the lab first, test what we have, and then go back and ask more people questions. Oh, okay, the mobile analysis unit. That's what he's talking about. That's a cool SUV. It's a bit dented up looking, but well, we got it. Fingerprints. We need to... Okay. That's not a good thing. They're not the exact same. In a bucket. Oh no. Oh no.
Ammo. Maya Ngyuen had her hands on the M4 assault rifle. GSR from the Vic matches the residue on Maya's hands. For Stan being a hands-on boss, our marketing gal got around too.
Oh no, so they match. But... So that's Maya's fingerprint, that's his fingerprint. But the fingerprint on the weapons case does not match to Maya's fingerprints. So we're still running a blank on that one. Maybe? Yeah, so we're still running a blank on that one. No, sorry. There's one. Yeah, so these... these don't match. Search A isn't it. B isn't it. And C isn't it. So we don't have a match on any of that. What we can do is test some blood. So they match.
Blood on the floor is Everston's, suggesting he was shot inside that demo room.
So we need to go back and do that.
We've done all we can do with that item.
I don't even know what this is. What is this? Mixed GSR updates? Let's say we've done everything. Oh, so no, I need another bullet. Hold on. Once I get another bullet.
That'll go on the assembly table.
Okay, gotcha. Where is the assembly table? Nick, I need an assembly table.
We've done all we can do with that item. We've done all we can do with that item.
And?
That'll go on the assembly table.
Okay, so I'm pretty sure I need the actual lab for the gun. Okay. I guess we can go to the morgue now, and we can ask them to get the body.
There's more to be done with the body at the crime scene.
Is there?
Make sure you've collected all evidence on the body itself and taken any photos nearby.
I'm pretty sure I got all the evidence. Oh, shit.
Yep, the ID confirms this is Stan Everston.
You know what sucks is that I moved my mouse on top of it and it was like, no, you're done, don't worry. Hoping we're done now, because I am... Oh, no, I already picked up blood samples. I picked up blood samples from the shirt and blood samples on the ground, which apparently he was dragged, which is what I assume this is. And then he was shot, it looks like point blank, on the head. Footprints? There doesn't seem to be any footprints nearby. We're just gonna try it one more time, see if that's all we needed. If that was all I forgot.
Sure, I'll send a team right out.
So apparently we just have to pick up his wallet. Alright, Doc, tell me what you get.
I would put it between 1 and 2:30 a.m. Normally a body cools at 1 to 1.5 degrees Fahrenheit per hour. But
yeah,
the officer at the scene reported the air conditioning was off all night, which throws off the standard computations.
What can we learn about the victim's blood loss?
With three shots to the body, blood loss collected from the floor is consistent. Your victim was very likely shot at that site.
What was the cause of death besides the one gunshot to the head?
Glancing at the body, I figured the shots to the chest were probably fatal. One penetrated the right lung and bounced around, filling the lungs with blood, suffocating the victim. Only that wasn't the case here. Not much blood in the lungs. The shot to the head was fatal. Once it entered, the brain shut down and immediately stopped all bodily functions. Note the scattered nature of the gunpowder specks surrounding the entry wound. Some burned, some not, indicating the shot to the forehead was fired 12 to 16 inches away. Here are the rounds from the chest cavity. They're 22 LR cartridges based on the 2.5 gram average weight.
Okay. So we can take that to the comparison table. Was the victim shot with a handgun or a rifle?
Could be either. Obviously a 22 rifle or pistol uses the same ammunition.
Hey, thank you, man. Thank you very much. Thank you for keeping me tabbed. Hope you're having a great night wherever you are. How can we determine the trajectory of the bullets?
Two very different angles of entry. Two straight on, relatively, in the chest, but the forehead shot indicates an upward angle. Since you found the bullet in the wall slightly above the victim's chest, this tells us our Vic had fallen before the fatal headshot was dispatched. I've got nothing new to report on the Vic. This is recent bruising within an hour or two of death, revealing a clear knuckled outline with a strange pattern. A ring, perhaps.
It's more like a bite. I'm no fucking detective. I don't know. So they let me get up close and not collect anything. Okay.
These marks are insect bites, or more precisely, stings. The tox screen isn't back, but these could be the work of a wasp. He was lucky to avoid infection, if indeed any murder victim can be called lucky. With fresh clotting like this, the man got stung within the last 48 hours.
Foot? Twice on the same foot? God damn. Man, that is some unlucky shit. You know, next to him being shot and killed. Alright, let's get to the lab. Do some comparison.
Striations from the bullet in the wall match the bullet in the victim.
Okay. So we got a match there.
Okay, let's fire a bullet from the 45. This will give us a striation sample. The 45 appears unmodified. It has three bullets in its clip. I processed the GSR from the 45's hammer. There's an anomaly, though. The 45 has two different variations of gunshot residue. One matches the 45, but the second is from some other bullet. I ran the serial number through firearms registration database, and the computer tells us this isn't a gun club gun. It was owned and registered to our victim.
Huh. Okay. Yeah, so these are two separate bullets. Obviously. But I got the red marking at the bottom, so we're good. What else do I need?
Let's run this evidence by brass.
Okay, so we'll give it to him. Maybe we can get more of a fingerprint analysis from the real computer. Not something from the back of the truck. Nope, same three. And I know it's from this fingerprint is from someone we haven't questioned yet, so we can't do anything. Go talk to Brad, see if we can get a warrant or something. Background check, there you go, that works. Can we get a background check on the victim?
I've been pulling double shifts due to the workload, but I was able to get this for you. Stan Everston. No priors, much less convictions. Pretty well off. At least enough so to live in Beverly Hills, CA. Wife's been at home all week with their newborn son. The late Mr. Everston was executive producer at LZP Entertainment. He's worked for several big companies in the game biz, worked on several high-profile titles. But he has a rep for pushing people to new heights, and sometimes pushing them too far. Finding enemies won't be a taxing task.
As it'd be like, finding enemies ain't gonna be a hard one, I guess. Alright, can we verify that the victim is sharing a room at the hotel?
Let me just check the computer. Okay, Mr. Everston was sharing a room with Andy Penmore. Next door is the gunslinging Ms. Maya Ngyuen. All checked in yesterday afternoon, Sphere Hotel.
And then we get a warrant for Maya Ngyuen. Yes, can I get a warrant to bring Maya in for questioning?
We have a very angry lady who likes to hold guns. And she also has GSR in her hands that matches the GSR on the Vic. Yeah, let's bring her in for questioning.
All right, first round of questioning. Don't know why I danced to that, but I enjoy watching people squirm like that when they know they could be the guilty party. I love watching them squirm in their seat trying to lie their way out of it. Did you place the gun in Stan's hands?
No!
Alright, I believe you. Alright. Call this case closed. It's a cold case now. She said no, I believe her. Move on to the next case. Alright, then why are your prints on the rifle, then?
I'm the one who rented the thing. Why wouldn't my prints be on them?
Why is there a GSR on your hands?
We were at a firing range, and, keep this to yourself, but I overslept after partying last night and skipped my shower.
Stu, you good-for-nothing two-phase line rat bastard. You may quite possibly be dumber than a bag of steaming horse shit. When I see you come on, I don't know what's worse. You? Wait, I don't know what is worse. You or world hunger. You stupid, inconsiderate, fucking sad excuse for a life. So how's the family? My man. I give it an 8.7 out of 10. Very classy. You kept this one very classy. Very, very classy. Thank you. How's the family? Family's doing great, though. Thank you for asking.
How about you, man?
How's your... I'm sure today's Wednesday. How's your Wednesday been? Not one insult still. I'd never insult you. I know. I just love seeing how cleverly written you can do these. Nope, nope. I saw that warning before it happened, because I had to take these headphones out. I'll bust my damn eardrums, and then I'd definitely be handicapped for working. Alright, I'm gonna get back to the questioning this possible guilty person. Oh, this is the regular hydrate. Okay, I'm good.
I created a team-building exercise to boost morale, to blow off steam. It was also part of our marketing position, how we put realism into the game. It was a photo op. We had our pictures taken while firing guns for sending out to the media.
Hydrate, you bastard! Hydrate!
Thank you, babe. Thank you very much. All right, who else was at the gun club?
It was our core team. Me, Stan, and Andy. Plus Craig. Stan invited him too, at Andy's insistence. I guess it was old loyalty to a founding member.
Oh, what weapons were you firing at this?
Couple of them. I kind of dig handguns. And they look good on me. Ever seen those Hong Kong action movies? Chicks with guns? I started with a 22, but it just didn't do it for me. So I switched to a 45. That one kicked ass. Oh, sorry. That must really sound in bad taste.
Where are the rest of the weapons from the weapon case, then? Because you're missing one grenade, the rifle that was on the ground, and I believe another thing from the case.
The rest of the weapons are still waiting to be picked up at the gun club. I brought the M4 assault rifle over early to ensure it would fit in the display.
Why'd you rent so many weapons, then?
The realism of our game stems from the fact that every in-game gun is modeled after the real deal. And we had them here at the booth to make that point. This industry is heavily male-oriented, including the retailers, and everybody knows boys like toys. So I brought the toys for the boys to look at.
That's what she said. Did you rent any real weapons?
No. We originally arranged to rent replica guns for the show, but when we picked them up, they all had a red cap on the muzzle. Gut Wrench 3 is all about realism. There's no way we can display weapons that are obviously toys. This was a last-minute wild idea I had, out at the gun club. I suggested we rent them from the club, and Stan loved the idea.
Okay, so where is this gun club?
I don't know exactly. I mean, I don't live here. I just hopped in a cab and said gun club. You're detectives, right? How about checking a phone book?
How about to smack the shit out of you, woman? Why were you wearing costumes at the booth?
Again, realism and promotion. All of us here would role-play a combat situation right in the booth, you know, every few minutes. Which is why I'm dressed for action. And sadly, Stan is too.
I don't understand. What's the point of play-acting shoot 'em up?
To bring the game to life. To make the buyers feel like they were inside the game. To stimulate them to see our game over every other one here. Listen, a trade show is a kind of carnival. And this was effective. And yes, it was my idea. And hey, I'd have gone farther with it if I could. I wanted to fire off blanks, but the fire marshal nixed it. Too unsafe.
So you had no form of live ammunition in your play acting?
Nothing.
Was Stan supposed to die during these reenactments?
Yeah, he was. Not for real, of course. But his role was to take the hit, yes, and I was the shooter. We rehearsed it a couple times, right before I left last night. I just point the empty gun at him, timing it to the demo, and mime to the game sound effects.
Okay, so why did you have a modified assault weapon in your booth?
We rented the weapons from the gun club. I have no idea if they were modified or not. I didn't purchase any ammo. They were for show only.
Then why was there a real 45 in the demo booth?
Stan couldn't see renting a 45 automatic when he just bought one. Sure, it was real. Hadn't been modified for safety, but hey, it was unloaded. And it's not like somebody would be walking around the trade show with a pocket full of bullets. Yesterday that sounded more reasonable, I admit.
Okay, so why did Stan buy the gun?
Well, he said he bought it for the company. It's the first weapon the art and sound staff used as reference. Andy thought he could program the game more realistically if he was familiar with the weapon, with its physics, as Andy put it. As I said, we are all about realism. The game has to be convincing. That's all I have to say.
Of course it is. That's all you have to say, my ass. Let's go to the motel. Motel. Holiday Inn. Hey, buddy. Look, just stares to the side like the fucking Terminator. Oh, hey, what's up? I'm gonna go through some of this shit first, if I can. Or not, I guess we gotta question him first.
Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough.
Yeah, nice salad. Granted, the last mission I played was like, looks like this place is clean, good job. When there was like a hidden fingerprint. So I don't know, I don't trust it. Are you Andy Penmore?
Perhaps you have some ID?
We're with the Las Vegas Crime Lab. We have a few questions.
Yes, I'm Andy Penmore. Is this about Stan? He never came home last night, but then this is Las Vegas.
I'm afraid Mr. Everston is dead.
Is this some kind of weird joke? Craig behind this, maybe? Or Maya? More of her off-the-wall publicity? I've been up all night slaving over some final tweaks Stan wants, and I'm in no mood for practical jokes.
No joke. He's dead. Murdered. In your demo booth.
No.
He was shot 3 times, Mr. Penmore. That's why we're here.
Oh my god. This is real. Really? Stan's my friend. He can't... We were just together last night, so... My god.
This is no game. This is real, Mr. Penmore.
You get it, because this is a game? But you're supposed to, you know... The situation is real. But this is a game. Life is a simulation. We're all just ones and zeros in someone's simulation. I don't know. Why do you think we have so much fun playing The Sims? Anyway, when was the last time you saw Stan?
Just last night, in the demo room, putting finishing touches on the presentation, looking for bugs, discussing these final tweaks. God, I can't believe this. I headed back to my hotel room at around 1 a.m. Stan wanted me to get on those fixes, and he stayed at the booth, preparing for the media demo today.
Alright, so was anyone else at the demo booth when you left? Was there anyone else at the demo booth when you left?
No, nobody I saw anyway.
Okay, well, mind if you tell me if you asked Stan to buy a gun?
Who told you that? Maya? Typical. Trying to make me look bad, take the heat off her after she was screaming at Stan, which is why she was having problems with him. You had to know how to handle that guy, and attacking and counterattacking was bad strategy.
If you don't mind, let's just get back to the question. Did you ask Stan Everston to buy you a gun?
Of course I did. How else could I program a game this realistic without understanding the actual physics of the key weapon? Also, our art staff needed it for reference. Is any of that hard to grasp? Look, I never shot anything more real than a super soaker. Not that Stan took much convincing. He'd been wanting to buy a gun for himself for some time. He had a genuine paranoid streak. Only now that he's a murder victim, he doesn't seem quite so paranoid, I guess.
That's a dark statement, my man. whose 45 ammo is in the gun, then?
It's Stan's. He bought it for his 45. He used it last night at the gun club.
So, might if we take a look around then?
Sure. This is a disaster, personally and professionally. I'll help in any way I can.
I was about to say, I'm gonna need your fingerprints and do a GSR test on you, brother.
Anything you need.
Alrighty. I wanna grab what's in here. Why won't it let me? You show me this bag, but you don't give me anything. Okay. I guess not.
Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough. Vic had a cell number.
Looks like this area is clean.
Recover a phone from the body. Did the killer lift it for some reason?
You were just ventriloquismly talking.
Looks like this area is clean.
Oh my
way
God.
To be thorough.
I think the game's freaking out on me. What is that?
Hey, a scorpion. Maybe we ought to call Grissom. Oh, I keep forgetting you're new. Grissom gets excited about bugs. Only, I don't know if you'd call this a bug exactly.
Ugh, she's got the chills. You get that with tweezers.
Not the right tool for this.
I don't want to touch it. I don't want to touch it.
Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough.
I think the game's freaking out on me. Telling me things are clean when after I pick things up.
Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough.
Why was that in his bed? Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough. Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough. I may need to come back to this place. Oh, wow.
Well, Miss Wynn painted a picture of a hype machine rolling happily along, but it looks like Stan the man was not so happy with her marketing campaign. That's pretty interesting.
Nope, that's it. Into the bathroom?
Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough. Hey, that's Fuzzy and Bill from that t-shirt we found. Looks like they've also been killed. Their video game got the axe. Looks like a number of hardcore fans were pretty teed off.
Game Nerd. I feel like that was a real website. I can't remember. The logo and the font look really familiar. I feel like Game Nerd was a real website. Oh, I could be wrong. Time. File's encrypted. Let's just take a.
Email's corrupted. A virus, maybe?
Possibly. We'll take it to the. Take it to the lab. I want to get in this bag, but it's not letting me. Why would they let me look at it? Did Stan have a cell phone on this trip?
Sure, of course. At a big show like this, he'd be dead without it. Well, sorry. Poor choice of words.
Did he have his phone when you last saw him?
Let me think. Yeah, he had it, because he text messaged me right after I got back to the room. Asked me to order a Cobb salad from room service and have it waiting for him. Thing's still sitting here, wilting.
Yeah, looks like it's been there for a couple of days, to be honest with you. What do you know about this note?
Just that I saw Maya wad it up and throw it at Stan yesterday, right after we checked in. She was pissed.
Then why was she so upset?
Actually, the surprise would have been for her not to be. You see, she and Stan, they've been at each other's throats for 2-3 weeks. It's been getting nastier and nastier as we got closer and closer to this show. They did not see eye to eye on the market strategy at all.
Okay, so whose bed was the scorpion in?
Stan's.
Okay, well... That was a quick just Stan. Do you know how it got in the bed?
Well, looks kind of bad, sort of sick at the moment, but I let this friend of ours do that as a practical joke. Thing was dead, couldn't hurt him, and Craig said Stan would get a kick out of it. Those two were always doing that kind of thing to each other, so I just went along.
Sounds suspicious. Was the scorpion alive when you put it in the bed?
Hell no, it was dead. Couldn't hurt him, or me for that matter.
So there is a website called Game Nerds. Yeah, so I knew that was real. I knew it, okay. Yay, old me, or younger me, I don't know. Hey, Barry, how are you? How's your night been? Alright, tell us about Craig Landers.
He's a game designer who was one of the founders of the company with Stan, even before I arrived. He left about a year ago. His sense of humor is kind of out there, call it an acquired taste.
Oh, you tired, Barry?
For example, just before he left the company, when he was working on Gutwrench 3, he put in a cheat code that lets you kill the boss. Of course, killing bosses is common in shooting games. At the end of a level, it's usually big bad guys or grotesque monsters or whatever. Not yuppie businessmen who look exactly like Stan Everston. You had to be there. Anyway, this was about the time Stan fired him.
Okay, where's Craig now?
Gee, I have no idea. He drove here on his own just to attend the trade show and hang out with us.
FBI, open up!
Pull those out of my ears faster. That sound is a lot more dangerous when I have headphones in. You had orientation for your new job? Oh, well, that's good.
I couldn't give you his license under hypnosis, man. It's some SUV, American make, I think. Ask Maya, why don't you? Craig was hitting on her pretty hard yesterday, and they were getting friendly. Saw him exchange phone numbers.
Is that your PDA in the bag?
Yeah, it is.
May we collect it as evidence?
Well, I know I said I'd do anything to help out, but there is a line. I have a lot of stuff coming through here, like time-critical bug reports on the game. I'm sorry, I can't give it up, especially since it has nothing to do with Stan's death.
Oh, I know it wasn't you this time, babe.
I've divulged everything I can think of.
But it did almost catch me off guard.
Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough.
I still want to take that melting salad. It looks like it's been sitting there for 50 days. Fifty days and 50 nights. Give me your phone. Yeah, it's from 2006. That's how old it is. Look at this. I found the game box too, like the actual box. Like, there you go. And it runs on Windows 10. Surprisingly, it does. It says supports Windows 98. ME 2000 and XP only. So yes, somehow it works. Oh, there was one for the PS2, there was one for the PS3, and I think I have one CSI game for the PS4. Could be wrong, but I know I have it on the PS3. I literally played it like a month ago. I was almost done with the game too, and then my PS3 died on me. It's a damn shame. There's a board game? How do you play this as a board game? mean, if it is a board game, it wouldn't surprise me. They did make board games out of, like, all, pretty much all the old TV shows that used to be on. Ah, so you are not the fingerprints on the weapon case. Nice to know. What else we got? Scorpion.
I would have encrypted this little number myself if I was standing up to a boss like that. I've printed this love letter out for you.
Oh yeah, there are murder mystery, but like, I know the one board game everybody had was Clue, and I love playing Clue. That was like one of my top favorites, like my top five favorite board games to play. I was actually pretty good at it. Just because you have no life doesn't mean I can't have. I work hard, and I like to work hard, but I won't burn myself out just to suit you. Keep pushing, and I will push back. Got it? Good, Maya.
We've done all we can do with that item.
Yep, I'm just putting all these up here. Oh, shit. Search.
Looks like our Vic was busy making friends right up to the end. With a text message this close to the time of death, this could have provoked an attack. Or the messages could have been sent after the murder. Maybe somebody used Everson's cell phone to send messages, throwing off the time of death.
Hey, how's the video game case going?
It's not game over yet. We've got some suspects, including a high-strung marketer, an aloof programmer, and a mysterious designer.
Any good physical evidence yet?
Nothing substantial, but it's still early in the case. We just ran his phone messages. It looks like he sent this message just before he died.
Maybe. Didn't Doc Robbins report the time of death was estimated? And you didn't actually find his phone at the scene.
If Stan sent the last message just before he died, where's his phone? Maybe someone else sent that message after the murder, and then toss the phone.
You know what Grissom would say.
Yeah. Follow the evidence.
That was a waste of my time because I didn't really listen to what they were saying.
We've done all we can do with that item.
Yep, just trying to get the red tag on it.
We've done all we can do with that item.
See, just trying to get this little red tag, just so I can...
We've done all we can do with that item. We've done all we can do with that item.
Thank you. I just need tags.
Let's see what Doc Robbins has to say about this.
Okay, we'll give it to Doc. This one's still missing because we do not have enough fingerprints. All right, Doc. I need to talk to you real quick about the Scorpion. I remember the OG CSI. Mom used to watch it a lot. Yeah, because this is CSI Las Vegas. This was the original CSI. And I used to watch it all the time, every time it was on. And I'd be able to guess who the fucking murderer was before the show was even done. Like, that's how much I watched the show when I was pretty good at it. My mom and my dad, and sometimes my brother would watch it. We would pretty much watch it all together.
Well, the tox screen is in. While there was no venom detectable in the bloodstream, a high number of antibodies were present, confirming the sting happened within 48 hours. Could be a yellow jacket, could be a scorpion.
What else can you tell me about scorpion stings?
Well, most of them are non-lethal, to adults at least. Worst case, the sting could have caused anaphylactic shock, like a bee or wasp sting. A severe reaction can cause death, but not in this case.
Oh, cool. Take the scorpion. Where do we go now? Right, let's go back to the crime scene and see. Yeah, so the rifle, the gun, missing something, and a grenade. That's all right, man. I'll still be here. You go get your tea, man. Gonna get ready for bed soon. All right. Listen, I'll be here till you're ready to go. Let's see. Maybe the cell phone could have been taken back to the hotel room, or not. Could be looking at toothbrush. No, like I said, what I'm missing now is the phone. It's taking me to this, but okay, so we'll do, there we go. What time did you get back?
I wasn't keeping track. Best guess, 1 a.m., a little after. Call it 5 after. Shouldn't be too hard. There's security cameras in the lobby. Can't you check those out?
That tells us what time you were in the lobby. But what else can you tell us?
Well, I remember I watched a pay-per-view movie last night. That's something the company doesn't pay for, by the way. Gotta cover all incidentals ourselves. Anyway, I've got the receipt right here.
Revenge of the Psycho Blood Mutants. Brass could check that out on the security cam footage.
Okay, so talk to Brass about that. Okay, so let me go question Maya one more time. It wasn't the drawer, we already... Actually, I didn't check that. Wait, what drawer? These drawers? No, we got nothing. We just had the guy's business card on the table. Alright, let's go talk to Brass. I want to question Maya some more. Ooh, there's a lot of things we can do. Let me talk to the suspect again.
She's on her way to interrogation now.
I may be able to get more information. Maybe. I highly doubt it. Ooh, there we go. Exactly how well do you know Craig Landers?
Hardly at all. I just met him yesterday evening at that gun club. Apparently, he helped LZP get off the ground, and of course, I knew about his game getting killed.
Andy says you were acting very friendly. Mind telling us what that was about?
What happened to... what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas?
You're still in Vegas. What happened?
Look, let's keep this confidential, because I got a life back home. Have you ever met somebody at a party or something and clicked and wound up in the backseat of a car?
No.
I found Craig a little bit cute last night, and I was half drunk.
When did you leave his car?
I left Craig around 1:30 or so, in the a.m.
And where is his car parked?
Garage, underneath the Sphere Convention Center. Only Craig isn't staying at the Sphere. Isn't staying anywhere, really. He's between gigs and on a tight budget.
What kind of car is it?
A new GMC Envoy. I even know his license plate because it was personalized after the characters in his game, Fuzzy and Bill. FZYBIL, I think.
All right, tell us about those angry notes on your marketing material.
Look, when you get hired for a job, it's because you got the right credentials, right? I've got a master's in marketing, but Stan thinks he knows how to do my job better because he's a guy. These last 2 weeks, man, they've been brutal.
What do you mean?
The company's come under a lot of critical fire lately, over the same old blah blah, excessive violence, lack of morality. I tried to tell him that negative publicity was a good thing, but he told me I just didn't get it. I'm a woman in a man's world, you know? If a girl doesn't play hardball, she gets rolled over. I've worked too hard to have some chauvinist like Stan keep me from reaching my goals. I mean, I'm sorry he's dead. He was talented. This wasn't anything you'd kill anybody over. I just... a professional disagreement that got a little ugly is all.
I don't know. I'm pretty sure people have killed for less. Or for more. I don't know, for both. Sounds like a misogynistic, sexist prick. From what she is telling me. Maybe not misogynistic, but like a sexist kind of, yeah. Could you explain the public reaction to canceling Fuzzy and Bill?
Craig started Fuzzy and Bill as an online comic, right? And then spun off into an indie comic book. Popular, but a cult thing. So when the game was announced, it was like, I don't know, the second coming or something to those comic nerds. So of course, they went postal when the game was scrapped.
How postal did they go?
They're hardcore fans of the comic, and a vocal minority that stirs up all kinds of online trouble. But they're still a minority. All talk and no sell-through. A few thousand crying fans is nothing when hit games sell millions of copies. I mean, have you heard of Fuzzy and Bill?
What I don't get is how this Fuzzy and Bill game is tied to launching Gut Wrench 3.
LZP is a successful company, for sure, but a small one. We only have so much personnel, and for that matter, cash flow. And anyway, my marketing research showed that another Fuzzy and Bill would never generate enough sales to break even, let alone show a profit. But Gut Wrench 3, on the other hand, builds on two enormously successful games and is what the mass public wants commercially. We'll achieve total market penetration with Gut Wrench 3. It's a no-brainer.
Okay, so why did you threaten Stan in an email?
I didn't threaten his ass. He was pushing too hard, and I told him to back off. That's no threat.
So when you say, keep pushing, and I will push back, you meant that in the nicest way.
All I meant was, clean up your act, or I'm out of here.
And why are you so ready to quit?
Listen, these video game guys, they're kids. Eternal kids. Well, I'm not a kid. But I do have a kid, a 10-year-old, who I like to see now and then on the rare occasion. And as a single mom facing week after week of extended periods of crunch time, well, enough's enough. It's just not worth it.
I think I feel when they just stare at you and I haven't made a selection yet. Or when they do that Terminator head turn. It's... I mean, this game was made in 2006. Like, you can't... I mean, I'm getting also, like... Knights of the Old Republic vibes from these animations. Like, it's old. This is an old game. So very old. Anyway. How are you doing, T-Mac? How you been? It's been a while. Do you have any other complaints about Stan?
How about a boss who demands everything and doesn't appreciate anything? A micromanager who changes his mind with the wind and saves up the biggest changes for the last minute. The smallest concern, the biggest ordeal imaginable. How's that for a complaint?
Anything else?
Well, Stan would go on and on and on about needing to get real, to bring the gritty reality of combat into not just the game, but my campaign, while dealing with a media backlash as well.
How can you reason with a guy like that? You tried at the gun club and it was like shooting blanks. So you decided to shoot him with something else.
And here's where I break down, right? Under your expert interrogation? Sorry. I hated the jerk. He was driving me insane, but I didn't kill him.
Yeah, I'm doing good. I'm just trying to live life one day at a time with the struggles that I'm going through. But I'm doing great. I'm doing great. I got amazing people backing me up day after day. So why did you reply to Stan's text message?
I'm a professional, but I'm human, okay? He was unprofessional and would not let the hell up, so I snapped back. That's one of those bad things about text messaging, you know? You wind up writing things you'd never say.
That's why text messaging is fun. Sometimes you're able to write things that you just can't say. Anyway, off to the car. Let's see if we can get some body fluids coming from that backseat. This lady is a cyborg. She has cybernetic upgrades and her finger gun went off. See, I told you he does that Terminator turn. I need your clothes, your boots, and your motorcycle. Alright. Let's see what this guy has to say. Nope, don't like it. Just babyface McGee over here.
I am indeed Craig Landers, game designer, visionary, master of the universe. I'd invite you into my office, but it's a little cramped. What's up?
I'm going to need to ask you some questions and force my way into your office, if you know what I mean. Ba-doosh.
Ooh, sounds serious. I'll see if I can whip up a few answers. Is it serious, guys?
When was the last time you saw Stan?
Must have been, yeah, last night sometime. Why, you looking for him? Try the LZP demo booth. Dude lives there.
Dude died there last night. Murdered Mr. Landers.
What is this? What, some kind of joke or something? Hey, you're not kidding, are you? Hey, that's crazy. He was breathing the last time I saw him, which must have been around 10 p.m. after the party. We walked to my car, here.
And how was your relationship with the man?
He was like my brother. I mean, LZP was our mutual thing, grew out of what we had. Which was a, well, friendship, but like all brothers, we had our problems, you know, business stuff.
But
we went back to the birth of LZP. Anyway, he invited me to this launch party last night, so you can see we were tight, even now. Of course, with a demanding dude like that, control freak, he's bound to rub people the wrong way. You'll have a lot of suspects to sort out. Maybe I can help.
Okay, then let me see your inside of your car, give me your fingerprints. I'm going to test you for GSR, and I'm going to end up having to bring you in for questioning later on. So that's how you can help.
Just happened to be between gigs, but with my rep, hey, I'll find something. One of the reasons I'm here at the show is to network and let people know I'm available. See, most designers would be at the show on somebody else's expense account, but right now, I'm on my own dime. Only, I don't have many at that.
And how long have you been parked here?
Since opening day of the trade show. Guys, you're not going to bust me for camping out, are you? I'm doing business. Give me a break. Have a heart. Don't make me move my wheels.
Parking garage security isn't the crime lab's deal, but I can see why you like the location. Pretty close to the convention center.
You're right about that. I'm not in Vegas for the gambling. A game expo like this is a prime opportunity for a designer like me to hook up with a new company. Easy for somebody with my record to talk to the top people and recruiters. Plus, I gotta stay current. See what the competition's up to and where the virtual world is heading.
Must be pretty tough playing video games all day.
Must be tough eating donuts all day. No offense, but as often as you hear that, I get what you said. This is a tough, demanding business. Kill or be killed. I meant that figuratively.
Did you see Maya last night?
Maya? Yes. Yeah, sure. Great girl. Woman. We connected. I've always had a kind of thing for Asian beauties, and she sure qualifies. And smart, and funny, wow. We took off after the party and had a few drinks and wound up in my little four-wheel suite here.
Did you discuss her outburst with Stan?
Maybe I better go for full disclosure here. One of the things we bonded over was our mutual frustration with Stan, and what a tyrant he's been lately. It's a bummer to think about now.
And what time were you two together?
Oh, well, I wasn't exactly watching my watch, but I'd say just before midnight. We were together in the on the back seat there till 1:30-ish. Tried to do the gentlemanly thing and offer her a ride, but she said, oh, don't be silly, she could walk. It was just one of the outlying buildings attached to the Sphere complex.
And where were you after she left?
Where else? So right here in my office, which is also my bedroom. I played a few games on my handheld and finally drifted off to sleep.
Okay, is this your fuzzy and girl shirt?
Yeah, there it is. I was handing them out at the show to, you know, hype up the characters. Where'd you find it?
We found this at the crime scene.
And why is your shirt torn?
I have no idea. Maybe someone tore one I handed out?
Or they used it as a silencer. Who knows? Or it was part of a scuffle, grabbed the collar and ripped it. Did you design the game scenario where you would kill Mr. Everston?
Game map of killing... Oh, come on, you can't be serious. That was a joke, an inside joke, which was the last thing I designed at LZP before we fell out, and I left the company.
Okay, what is Stan's reaction to your game map?
Surprisingly, he wasn't thrilled. He had a sick sense of humor. We had that in common, a kind of dark, practical Joker streak, so I thought he'd laugh. But all of a sudden, Stan reacted like he'd grown a stick up his butt. That was the last reason I needed to hasta la vista.
All right, then why did you leave the company you helped form, Mr. Rogers?
It was just time. I'd been in on the ground floor of LZP and helped guide its direction for years, but Stan was moving us into increasingly more violent games, and I was thinking we were getting... I'm no prude or censor, but we were definitely skirting the edge of irresponsible, okay? Kids get access to these games, even the restricted ones, and I got into this field to give players entertainment, challenging entertainment sometimes, sometimes just sheer fun. But blowing people away in increasingly realistic explosions of blood and brains and bone, well, let's just say it wasn't my dream.
Okay, so doing a complete 180 here. Did you put the scorpion in Stan's bed?
I'm staying perfectly straight with you guys. Yes, I put it there. It was one of the little guys I rounded up out in the desert.
Why'd you put it in his bed?
Haven't you heard anything I've said? We were practical jokers. Stan and me, even Andy. I know it sounds like bizarre video gamer bonding, but it's true.
All right, we're going to take a look inside your love and... yes, okay.
I've told you everything I know.
Do some more questioning real quick. How long did you work for Stan?
Since the start of the company. I was the first guy he hired. He could be a tough guy to work for, but we were also friends. Anyway, it was his dough and his contacts in the biz that got the company off the ground. Of course, it was my contribution, my game code, that made the play.
I'm okay. Pretty sure I just blew out both my eardrums doing that. But I think I'm okay.
I write the programming code. Back in the early days, programmers like me were God. We designed the games, created the artwork, did all the programming. Only as the industry's grown, it's got more specialized. So my code is still what makes it all happen. I am Gutwrench 3.
Hi, Barry. Nice to see that you're back. I'm pretty sure I just blew both my eardrums. I made hot dog wraps. That sounds interesting. Is that a hot dog, but inside a tortilla?
Well, like I said, leave isn't exactly the word. The dude was canned. And he hasn't been able to land a job ever since.
Watch your profanity!
Living out of his damn car, you know.
Craig didn't mention being fired. You sure he didn't leave on his own?
Dude, I was there. It was a raving blowout between those two. As for what was behind it, well, we were all working on Craig's little game, Fuzzy and Bill. We slaved on it for months and months, and it sold squat. It was total hard drive crash to Craig's ego when Stan pulled the plug on the promised sequel. Canceling the game was a shock, but Craig held on, thinking he could design Gutwrench 3. All through development, those two were at each other's throats. And last night, they picked up right where they left off, screaming Match City.
Anna.
We were at the demo booth, getting it ready, and I took a break. Shouldn't have left those two alone, I guess. I could hear them yelling at each other, really tearing each other bloody gaping new ones. Oh, I'd forgotten about that. I do remember Stan bitching about his foot itching. He said he'd got a couple of muscle tremors before he
threw out. Everybody!
No problem. Here you go. Line of Fire Gun Club, 3727 North Ralston Avenue. Yeah, I had the phone company track it to a general area using the GPS. It just arrived.
Iglesias finally got the phone. Of course, it was in a dumpster near the convention area. Your convention center. Of course it was. We got it. I was going to say thumbprint, but I don't know what finger that is.
The security chief at the Sphere says their videotape puts Andy Penmore returning at 1:08 a.m. and staying put. Maya didn't get in until 2:15, giving her a half hour to do who knows what. With the hotel connected to the convention center, she has opportunity. All right. She's on her way to interrogation now.
I don't know if I have any more questions for her. I'm just checking, just in case. So where were you between 1:30 and 2:10 a.m.?
We have security video showing you getting back to your room half an hour after you left Craig's. Your hotel room is less than 5 minutes away. What, you stopped to gamble?
No, I'd already gambled enough going for a one-night backseat stand. In fact, I sat at the curb and just held my head in my hands and thought about my life
Scooper,
and my kid
doing?
And...
How are you doing tonight?
I said I was human. A tired human who let go of...
I got a bad feeling about this.
Actually, I felt good.
Did you see the fight between Craig and Stan?
No. I know Craig wanted his job back. Maybe my looks and charm weren't the only thing Craig saw in me. Maybe he also wanted to know about the state of office politics. Anyway, in his car we were griping about Stan, and Craig told me he tried to talk to Stan back at the convention center, but that it hadn't turned out so hot.
I mean, I could put an ad on. Do you want me to put an ad on? It'll give me time to do things. Then what are you doing redeeming ad time? I'm kidding. Need to go to the lab. You don't know. Let me see. Fingerprints, we're gonna see if these match. Motherfucker.
We've done all we can do with that item. Let's run this evidence by brass.
Can we already do that? We're gonna go to the gun shop.
So the crime lab's back. I was just thinking about you because our new Gun Club magazine came in. And it's got an article about something you were asking about, modifying guns. Take one. They're complimentary.
Thanks.
What can I do for you, officers?
Las Vegas Crime Lab. We have a few questions we need to ask. Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough.
It's never clean, don't believe it.
Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough.
Is everything? Yes, that's everything. All right, talk to her. What services do you offer? Ma'am.
Our claim to fame are the public firing lanes we offer, 50 feet long. Patrons can rent weapons from us or bring their own. We offer guns for purchase as well, and our members get lower prices, lower rates on our services. We're responsible operation officers. We're all about gun safety here. Offer classes for the whole family. But we also offer a tactical training course to police and military personnel. I'm sure some of your colleagues have utilized our services. For example, our changeable walkthrough course with simulated real-world environments.
Did a group come in here yesterday evening?
The only group we had was from a video game company. A small group, just four. But they charged it on a company card.
Company card? Did you notice anything unusual with the group?
Actually, yes. You see, people usually come out for one of two reasons. To have a good time, or to do some serious training. These four, well, if I had known what kind of mood they were in, I don't know if I'd done business with them. They were at each other. Really nasty insults. Arguments. Two in particular.
Which couple was, arguing?
A young Asian woman and an older guy. Handsome, I'd say. They were in a huge fight. I mean, over the top to where I thought they might come to violence. Which is not good in this environment. I came out and told them to get their act together, or they'd be out on the sidewalk where they could fight without guns in their hands.
Okay, so when were they here then, if you don't mind me asking?
We can check the sign-in sheet for sure, but best I remember, in the evening, around 8 till maybe 10.
All right, can we take a look around?
We are pro-police here at the gun club. You guys are the first line of defense, and we back you all the way. Private lane number one is still in the condition they left it, so... Hey, do your thing.
A useful list of who had brought what to the party.
Alrighty. Did Maya rent a set of firearms from you?
Set of firearms? More like an arsenal. But understand, we don't rent out functioning firearms. Well, they function to a degree, but they're modified for non-lethal pellets. You know, for legal reasons.
What kind of non-lethal ammo does it fire?
Paint bullets, but not paintball exactly. These are the smaller variety pellets used in high-tech tactical training. These suckers pinpoint. And just because you can't get killed doesn't mean you want one of these paint pellets pelting you. They leave a whale of a welt.
Okay, could real ammo possibly be fired from these rentals?
No. Not without substituting a real barrel onto the weapon. And even then, a special adapter has to be installed. And, well, it would be more trouble than it's worth. And we don't rent the real barrels out, if that's what you're thinking.
Okay, did anyone bring their own weapon?
Seems to me one of them did. But I'm hazy on who, and what caliber the weapon was. I mean, I see so many guns in this place. But it'll be on the sign-in sheet. We're all over it when somebody brings their own gun into our space.
Did anyone purchase a weapon here?
Now that you mention, the one who seemed to be the boss, fella who paid for the session, Stan Everston, he bought a 45 auto and some ammo for it.
Okie dokie, artichoke. Let's go see what we got going up here.
Creepy. Ooh. Harrow. Someone's got a picture over there. 3, 4, 2, 1. Why am I allowed to be here without being here? Oh, there you go. Oh, hey. Look who it is. It's
Stan.
Wow,
look at that grouping. That kind of shooting takes considerable practice.
I'd say so. Is that all? I was hoping we'd get some fingerprints or something, but apparently we're not getting any.
But looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough.
Some nasty ass looking food on this table. Certificates.
Looks like this area is clean. Way to be thorough.
I don't believe you when you say the area is clean.
I can't think of anything else for you.
There's nothing there.
Looks like this area is clean.
All right, so who are we going to then? I guess we'll go to the crime lab real quick. Hold on, we'll go ask this guy. We'll do some more questioning.
I've divulged
to everyone we know. There you go. Do you own a 22 Eagle?
Yeah. Legally purchased in California and registered to me. Why?
Why'd you bring the gun to Vegas?
Did I break some statute or something? It's just Stan and Andy suggested I bring it. Something about getting the team into the reality behind first-person shooting games. Stan knows. Knew. I have a gun and know my way around firearms. I thought I could give the gang a few tips.
Warrant. There's a warrant. Mind if we look around your car? Actually, did you argue with Stan in the demo room?
Where didn't I argue with Stan? We fought like brothers.
We're gonna
I told
look
you
at
that.
His car last.
Why?
Gonna...
Did that creep Andy say? Look, it's no big deal. I don't know what Penmore's problem is anyway. Hell, I'm the one on the outside. He's the one with part ownership of LZP now. He was the new brother. Replaced me in Stan's heart and company.
So why did you make, why did you quit, or did you quit, or were you fired?
Technically, I was fired, but let's just say I already had my desk cleared out. Why does that matter?
What was the reason you were fired?
The real reason, or the stated one? Because, you see, officially, I wasn't a good fit with the new vision of the company, but really, it was our disagreement about the future of LZP. And my desire to have a little goddamn responsibility about who we were selling our products to. The pisser is, I get so steamed just thinking about it. I trusted him when we set things up. So he wound up owning my intellectual property. And I'm left at square one.
And what intellectual property did Sam keep?
I created the original Fuzzy and Bill online comic years ago, way before LZP. Then I sold Stan the full commercial rights for $1, on the understanding that he would make it into a game, with me in for a big share as an employee of LZP. We published, the game didn't sell big, but it had a following. Stan decided to bury Fuzzy and Bill, not just the video game, all other merchandising too, just to put me in my place.
I feel like we found
there the property sits, still at LZP, and here I sit, out of work and no way to make a nickel on my own creation.
Pretty convinced he might be the killer. Yeah, so why are your knuckles red?
What? Oh, that. It'll sound lame, but I was out in the desert catching scorpions the other day. Little critters scurry around the rocks, you know, and these are my, red badges of stupidity.
You telling me you actually got into a fist fight would sound less lame. You could save us a step by letting us take an impression of your ring. We can get a warrant. Easy, but...
I got nothing to hide. Actually, I got nothing, period.
A ring. Okay, cool. Why did you make the target of Stan's face?
Back in better days, Stan and I shared a kind of warped sense of humor. Maybe I was trying to get that back, or maybe I was just trying to get back at him. But it doesn't matter, because I didn't even shoot it. That was Maya.
All right, we're just going to take a look around your car.
Hey, I do want to help, but they say a man's home is his castle, and right now, these wheels are all the castle I've got. I know all about my rights, including you needing a search warrant first.
Can we get your fingerprints to do a GSR test?
That I'll do. I'm not trying to be a jerk or anything. Stan's death is a shock to me. Do your tests.
Finally. Okay, so I need a search warrant for his vehicle. Let's go here. You son of a bitch.
Craig had his hands on the weapons case. Another potential link to the crime scene.
So you are the one with the... Got it, okay. That's for Brass.
Let's run this evidence by Brass. We've done all we can do with that item.
I know, I'm just trying to get this little red tag. Tell me it all you want.
We've done all we can do with that item. There's more to do with this evidence before we can process it.
Is there really? Oh, fingerprint. She already admitted to it.
I'm starting to wonder how anti-violence Craig Landers really is.
Pretty violent, my man. Pretty violent.
We've done all we can do with that item.
So...
Let's see what Doc Robbins has to say about this.
So we gotta go to Doc. Then we'll go to Brass.
And then we'll ask for a search warrant.
Does this ring match up with the bruise on the victim?
The bruising patterns match up to these
markers.
All right,
Barry, have a good night. Sleep well.
Also, the bruise had a very large white blood cell count, which only happens when the person hit is alive.
That means this ring struck Stan Everston before he died.
Off to Brass, let's get a search warrant and whatever else we can get.
We have a strong connection here. The bullet's a .22, he owns a .22, his shirt is at the scene, and Landers has a bit of history with our Vic. The search warrant will be for a handgun or handgun accessories.
I mean, I can't grab anything else? That fucking sucks. Let me see if
she's
Maya...
on her way to interrogation now.
Yeah, let's see if Maya has anything else to say. Did you agree with Stan at the gun club?
Argue is a little strong. We raised our voices,
sorry,
but...
Agree.
Hell, it's loud in a firing range. I guess maybe I started to kid him, you know? And it got out of hand.
Have there been any other disagreements between you two?
Just childish crap. Like this insulting text message he sent me the other night. Really pissed me off.
And what did the text message say?
Oh, hell, I don't remember. I mean, it's a dead issue, right? Sorry. That sounded bad. I just mean... The guy's gone. Let's cut him a break.
Did you shoot at this picture?
So what if I did? Craig plastered that pic on the target. I took aim and showed them my stuff. Gotta give Stan credit. He laughed. For a while.
Your shooting is better than some CSIs.
Maybe you guys ought to join the gun club. Me, I was raised around firearms. My dad was ex-military and his big hobby was hunting. Plus, I didn't have any brothers, and kind of went the tomboy route to please Daddy, who trained me in guns from grade school. But I never could bring myself to shoot animals, so I was strictly a target range girl, and I have the medals to prove it. I used my experience to help Andy with his in-game physics simulations. Not that he showed any gratitude. After all, I'm only marketing. He's the coder.
Alright, so now we can go back to the... Let's go talk to Stan, was his name?
I've divulged everything I can think of.
Okay, fine. Don't talk to me then. I'm gonna go to his car. And we have a search warrant.
Oh, crud. Wait. I demand to see a lawyer. I know my rights.
You watch too much TV, man. Stay nearby in case we have any questions.
And to the car. Ah,
scorpion collectors. I just don't get it. Luckily, this is not covered by our warrant.
Yeah, luckily.
This guy takes his gaming seriously, but it's not covered by our warrant. Ah, yes, the mysterious 22. At last we meet.
I may have to take this to the assembly table. Do some tests on it. But we are only here for the gun.
I've told you everything I know.
Assembly table it is. Then we could do some shooting tests.
The weapon's unloaded, but the barrel's been tampered with. Somebody scraped the inside of it. Maybe they were trying to discourage ballistics matches. The gunpowder from Lander's 22 matches the second type of powder found on the 45 automatic?
How does that work? Hold on.
The striations don't match, which is not a shock, considering the barrel's been tampered with. So I'm not ready to rule this out as the murder weapon. It would be nice to know whether this gun was futzed with before or after the crime. Our ousted game designer either knowingly or unknowingly provided the bullets that killed his former boss. The problem is, somehow all three of our suspects fired these rounds. The electron microscope confirms the gunpowder found on the forehead wound matches all three of our suspects' hands. This definitely muddies the water a little bit.
A little bit? Are you kidding me?
What's up?
We have a real mystery here. Let me lay it out for you. We have a 22 caliber bullet that we found in the body. Its GSR matches this box of 22 bullets. We also recovered a 22 handgun owned by one of the suspects and have found the same GSR traces on it.
Okay.
But ballistics don't match, so this weapon didn't actually fire the bullets into the Vic.
Sounds like you need to find a different 22.
Well, there's one more twist. The 45 handgun we found at the crime scene also has traces of the 22 bullets GSR on its hammer. But, as you know, it can't fire 22 round.
That's true. But didn't I overhear something about modified rifles from the gun range?
Yeah, but that's out. It only fired paint pellets.
Same concept, Nick. How do you fire a non-standard bullet from a weapon? Modify the weapon. I'd go back to the gun shop and see what else they know.
To the gun shop, then. Should have talked to Brass, though. Do you sell conversion kits for 45 to 22?
We don't stock them, but they're easy enough to special order. Those kits are fairly popular, because they let you train with less expensive rounds. 22s are way cheaper than 45s, and more common, too. Heck, around here, you can buy 22 cartridges at convenience stores.
Did you sell the adapter to anyone in the video game party?
No. The only thing they bought was bullets.
How hard is it to install an adapter?
You don't have to be a gunsmith. Anybody who knows his or her way around a gun could do it in a couple of minutes. Don't even need special tools. Would you like to order one?
No, thanks. We have our own sources.
Can you collect a 22 round fired by the game group?
No problem. I'll pick one out of the wall for you.
So we could try to match that to the other bullet.
I can't think of anything else for.
So first, let's go back to the lab, compare bullets.
Hey, I didn't have to go far to get that gun adapter after all. Local police reserves had one. Take this and do your test.
Okay, thanks.
We can definitely rule out Craig Lander's .22 handgun as the murder weapon. The bullet fired at the gun club does not match the bullets from the victim.
Okay.
That'll go on the assembly table.
I figured.
Good job. Next stop, ballistics lab.
I don't even know what bullet I have on there now. Oh my god, okay. Hold on. The adapter.
The striations on the spent bullets are similar, but not exact, to those found in Everston's body. This is not surprising. Since our adapter clearly didn't shoot him, we need to find the actual adapter to confirm it.
Didn't think I'd have to go all the way back to like one of the first bullet cases that I had. Alright, next is Brass. We gotta go talk to Brass. Can you look for a gun adapter?
I'll get my boys to start searching for it immediately. Check back later.
And then can I get a warrant? For Craig Lander's. To interrogate.
Sure. Let's bring in the guy whose ring matches our Vic's chest.
Alright, more questioning for Craig. How did the inner barrel of your gun get scraped?
Well, you tell me, detective. I let all of them, Maya, Andy, even Stan, fire my gun that night. Any of them could have screwed with it. Hey, you don't think one of them's trying to frame me for this thing, do you?
Well, I think we can safely rule Stan Everston out, but I can see why you'd be pissed at Stan the man. Cancels your pet project, fires you, and keeps ownership of a company you built as much as he did.
Every game company has conflicts between the creative and business side, okay? Producers like Stan don't look at a monitor and see the energy and the brilliance that go into a great game. All they see is a damn spreadsheet. He didn't hold a gun to my head and make me sell my intellectual property to him. That was my stupid fault.
All right, so how do you know Stan would be at the convention center after the party?
Well, during the party, Andy told Stan that there were new bugs with the game, and Stan, being the predictable control freak he was, had to go there and hunt down the bugs personally. He would have stayed there all night if he needed to.
So you went begging for your job back?
Not begging. Look, it was all business for Stan, and I was talent, and damn good talent. I figured he'd be able to look past our differences and see how I could positively impact his bottom line. And, hey, I admit, I thought that maybe after Gut Wrench 3 came out, we could revive Fuzzy and Bill again.
How did that go over with Stan?
Not so good. I pushed too hard, and we both said things that old friend should never have said. He said LZP had outgrown me, and I accused him of bad-mouthing me in the industry to where I couldn't even get a low-end job. I admit it. It got a little ugly. I accused him of exploiting every worst instinct in the gaming market, selling violence and sex, made all the worse by killing the very game that could have provided a fun alternative. And if he wasn't going to do Fuzzy and Bill, couldn't he at least sign it back over to me? He just laughed.
So that's when you threatened Stan? Hoping to scare him into giving you Fuzzy and Bill back? He didn't back down, even when you punched him. He took it, and then ripped your shirt as you fled. But you went back for your gun instead. With Stan gone, LZP would turn to you. You'd put the company back on track.
You got it half right anyway. I took a swing at that prick. And I'm guilty of getting my butt kicked by the guy after. I just picked up what little was left of my dignity and I went back to my car. That's everything I know.
I am legit running a blank on where I need to be right now. Maya has no alibi.
She's on her way to interrogation now.
Maya, give me something. Give me some good information. Or just tell me you did it. Either one. Either one. How did Andy and Stan get along at work? Let me know.
They had a lot of history before I got there, you know? Like, they had tension sometimes, but there was also a bond. Almost like they could read each other's minds or something. By the end of the project, they were mostly staying out of each other's way. And, you know, maybe I'm out of line for saying this, but I don't know why Stan trusted the guy. Word around the office was, Andy's an old-school hacker.
What kind of old-school hacker?
The kind who likes to break into stuff. Recently, I let him install a version of Gut Wrench 3 on my computer. Only since then, my machine's been working really, really slow. Andy says he did nothing, but I think he accessed my files.
Huh. Andy, are we gonna have to have a conversation again? Okay, let's go talk to... Are you part owner of LZP Games?
Actually, no, but I should be soon. Stan promised me a piece of the corporate pie because of my stellar work on Gut Wrench 3. It's not supposed to happen till the game's complete and on the shelves. And that'll be delayed because of this tragedy. But we didn't have anything in writing, but there were witnesses to our oral contract. But I'm not the only one who was promised a payday. Let me give you a different file, one that I think you'll be more interested in. It's on my PDA. I've divulged everything I can think of.
I still need to get this file in this note. They look... Oh, okay, there we go. Ow, that hurts. Well then, let's just get all up in there. Alright, got some files. Ow. Just wanted to check.
I've divulged everything I can think of.
Okay, let's go to the lab, get it checked. Ah, it's all red. Okay, so apparently there's nothing left here. So back to the lab. Race. Documents is where I need to be.
Press coverage of Gut Wrench 3 is tied to Maya Ngyuen's payday. The bigger the media splash, the bigger her bonus. However, note that it was encrypted. Andy didn't just get this forwarded, he hacked it.
This game reaches attention in the national press. You will be in the position to make hundreds of thousands of dollars, as well as a name for yourself in the industry. But this game needs to sell, and you need to sell it. Get on it, Stan. Okay. So then, I guess we go back to talk to Maya again.
She's on her way to interrogation now.
Talk about this hacked email. When did you get the marketing bonus contract?
From day one. It was part of the job offer that convinced me to sign up with LZP. I had offers from two other companies. Both bigger, you know. But this was a real opportunity to make my mark. And a box of money.
Why would a marketing person rate bigger money than the creative side?
Marketing is king in the entertainment world. And the game industry is an increasingly bigger part of that world, with marketing campaigns that run to the millions. More sometimes than goes into the game themselves. A great game that sits on a shelf is a flop. A weak game that flies off the shelves is a win.
And we're looking at a crime scene that seems designed by a marketing whiz. Aimed at generating a lot of press. Vic posed like the body on the game's poster. It's genius, really.
And here you are with a sweetheart contract tying national press to your bonus. Nicely done, Ms. Nguyen.
With your expertise as a competition shooter, you know all about weapon adapters. Then you heard about Craig and Stan getting into it, so you seized the moment, killing your pain of a boss, posing him for the inevitable press coverage, placing the assault rifle just right, though leaving a nasty little print behind. Then back to your hotel room.
You're right. The killer did me a favor. And I'll probably make money because of the way that crime scene was staged. But I didn't stage it, and I didn't kill Stan. But maybe I can help you. Why don't you take a look at a file I downloaded for you about Andy Penmore? It's on my flash drive. You might get somewhere with it.
Was she just holding this in like a holding cell?
That's all I have to say.
Back and forth, back and forth, back and forth.
Let's run this evidence by brass.
This is for your eyes only. Maya, I've indicated a handful of people at LZP, Andy Penmore included, that I'm thinking of giving them some small but significant ownership participation. Perhaps someday I'll be able to keep that promise. But for now, the best thing for LZP is the success of Gutwrench 3. Toward that end, I'm canceling all plans for profit sharing to maintain my ability to pay out your bonus per our contract. Everything is riding on this, so you'd better earn your bonus, Stan. Yep, let's go to brass. Have you made any progress finding the murder weapon?
Catherine gave me the heads up on this development. Our convention center security pals used a metal detector around where that cell phone was recovered. Here's your adapter. Oh, you're gonna love this. Turns out both of these items were within 30 feet of Lander's car.
Nice. Okay, so we need to put this. Crap in a bucket. Back to the lab again. Let's get...
There's more to do with this evidence before we can process it.
Oh yeah, fine. I saw that and I was like, I don't need that. So we got that.
That'll go on the trace analysis computer.
Yes, I know. There we go. Take that out, take this out, put that on, load that in.
Good job. Next stop, ballistics lab.
Ballistics lab. Alright. I don't even know what bullet I'm supposed to be comparing it to anymore. There's so many fucking bullets that I have.
Yeah, and that's our murder weapon. Back together again for this special encore performance.
Evidence file updated. Okay. So we still need to go to the fingerprint. We got fingerprints to do. We got new fingerprints.
Penmore had possession of Stan Everston's cell phone, and now we have Andy's fingerprint on the gun adapter, tying him to the murder weapon.
Uh-oh. So you know what that means, right? It doesn't even let me do it because it's a partial, which is kind of dumb. I think there'd be enough. I feel like there's enough in there. Did it say for me to go to Brass, or did it tell me to go talk to him again? I'm gonna go talk to him before I talk to Brass.
I've divulged everything I can think of.
Okay, well, talk to Brass then. Let's get a warrant. An arrest warrant for Andy Penmore.
Andy's prints are on the Vic cell phone and on the murder weapon adapter. Time to stop all the games and play for real. Let's arrest this guy.
Where do these people come up with these sayings? Like, on the spot. Andy. I'm sure you still left that cop salad sitting on that table in your hotel room. Disgusting. When you know he wasn't coming because he's dead. I don't know why you left it. Why you leave it? It's just disgusting. But anyway, have you been working as much as Maya lately?
As much? More. Try 8 days in a row. My eyes are burning right now from sitting at a monitor, making this game fly.
Was that what you bargained for?
Actually, yes. Everybody in the game industry knows that long hours is part of the deal. I'm in this field because I love it. I'm a lucky guy, making games for a living.
Okay, well, have you seen this document from Stan?
What is this, some stupid attempt to entrap me?
It's no fake, Andy.
Well, then Stan Everston was a fake. If this is true, he was planning to renege on my piece of the action. Bastard lied to me. If I'd have known this, you really would have a right to look at me as a murder suspect. But I didn't know, and I didn't kill him. Though I'd like to strangle his ass right now.
Well played, Andy. But a gifted hacker like you? You've known about that email all along.
You're reaching, but you aren't touching anything. Read my lips. I never saw this stupid thing before. Anyway, when Stan was killed, my stake in the company hadn't kicked in yet. What would I have gained killing that liar?
You didn't have a stake yet, and you found out you never would. Not unless you removed Stan and brought in witnesses who heard his oral contract to you.
Andy, we found the cell phone, we know about the adapter, and your prints are on it. Then there's the little matter of you being the last one to see Stan Everston alive.
I wasn't the last one to see him alive. The killer was. You don't play this game at all well, guys, but good luck to you. Everybody's got to start somewhere. Am I free to go?
We all know you killed Stan Everston. I don't know why you're fighting. You're already wearing orange just like the jumpsuit that you're going to be wearing for the rest of your godforsaken days.
How could I do that from my hotel room, which is where I was when he was killed?
Sure you were. There's no proof of that, by the way. Just flimsy setups from you to make us think you were there.
If that's the best you can do, I can't wait to see you try to build a case on air like this in court.
You're right, we don't have the evidence we need, but we have a lot of testimony. Help us find the real killer, since you're innocent and all.
I see. You pretend to ask for my help when you really want me to try to incriminate myself. Give you false testimony on facts so you can trip me up. If I don't, then I'm unwilling and you hold me longer. So, on game, I'll help you.
Okay, well then, who convinced Stan into inviting Craig, persona non grata, to the gun club party?
I did. I don't deny that.
Who also told Craig to bring his own 22? Who ensured Stan bought and brought his 45? Who researched how weapons work in the real world? Who told Stan there was a last-minute problem with the game, ensuring he would stay late at the demo center?
I did, but none of that means I killed him, of course.
Well, I'm just getting started. Who knew that an adapter for both a 22 and a 45 would be needed for this coincidence? Who knew Maya not only had a PR bonus, but was also an expert shot? Who was ready with flimsy alibis when the others decided to hook up on an accidental meeting? Who set this whole thing up months in advance the minute you found that email telling you your payday was gone the way of floppy disks?
You can't prove that.
See, this is what we can prove.
Let me walk you through what we can prove, thanks to your help. By ensuring both the 45 and the 22 would be at the club, you could grab a few of Craig's bullets. When you told Stan there were problems with the game, he gave you the 45 and the ammo to take back to the room while he went to the convention center. You walked through the lobby so the cameras could see you, entered the room, ordered your movie, modified the gun, and then snuck out. Once in the demo room, you cranked up the game audio and shot Stan twice in the chest and once in the head. Then, you staged the crime scene to potentially throw blame on Maya or maybe just some disgruntled fan. You also turned down the air conditioning to further confuse the time of death. You switched out the adapter, wiped the 45 clean, and returned it to the gun case. Then you grabbed Stan's cell and punched in your second alibi and bolted back to your room to order that alibi salad. You wiped off the phone and adapter, and the next morning, you ditched him near Craig's car. Easy to find, right? However, in your haste, you left partial prints on both items. Then it was off to the convention, from one con right into another.
You see, Andy, we're not trying to get you to incriminate yourself. You said that you'd help us. The truth is, we don't need anything from you. We know what you did, and we know how you did it. Combined with all the physical evidence we got on you, we have everything we need.
No, you'll never make this play in court.
This murder was all a game to you, wasn't it? But there was a glitch in your programming. It's your sick ego. And that's a bug you'll never get out of your system.
That was an interesting case. It's funny. Andy tried so hard to control every detail to cover up his involvement. And since you uncovered that every detail was controlled by him, that was the break we needed. Physical evidence is strong, but it's the context of that evidence to the events that makes it the strongest. Well done. Let's move on to your case evaluation.
You investigated every possible angle on this case. Doesn't happen often, but I'm very impressed.
Current ranking master. Fuck yeah. Oh my god. Who would have known it was the fucking programmer? Actually, kind of probably gave some hints. But yeah. That was intense. That was fun. That was actually really, really fun. And I will definitely have to do this and do the next mission with y'all some other time. And make sure I don't screw up as much as I just did. Which was me having to go back and be like, I think I forgot this. Or I needed to ask, or I think I need to go talk to someone and be a whole line of questions. I'm like, ah, crap. Oh, but that was fun. I'm definitely going to be doing this game again. Most definitely. Oh, man. A game that is so fucking old. 2006. Oh my lord. This game is old enough to drive. That is how old it is. Fucking 16 years. More surprised it actually works. I tried installing what was it? The Oregon Trail 2 or 3. I tried installing that. It wouldn't run. It was like, I think it only ran on, I don't know, I'd have to look it up. It was sad. I wanted to play that one, but that game just doesn't run. Most of my PC games don't run on this little CD drive thing that I got, but that's okay. I'm still pulling out old PC games that I got hidden away in my closet, so... Yeah, I'll see what games actually work, which ones don't. Separate them, that way I don't waste time on trying to work them in. But yeah, that was CSI Crime Scene Investigation, Three Dimensions of Murder. Thank you everybody for coming in. Thank you for helping me with this, babe. Thank you, Short Stuff. Thank you, Barry. Thank you, Scoober. Thank you, T-Mac. And I believe we had one more. Thank you, Neighbor, for that very beautiful introduction. Every time you come in, you know I love him. And Steez, thank you very much for keeping me tabbed. Much greatly appreciated. And I believe that was all of y'all. Thank you very much. And for those that are just like sitting here just watching, not being a part of the chat, thank you very much for doing that. I appreciate y'all being here, but don't be afraid to talk in the chat. We're nice people. At least some of us are. I could be mean. I could be a lot more mean, but I'm not going to. Like I said, this was a fun game. I think I'm going to play it again. Possibly. I might make this one of my Tuesday, Wednesday game streams. Or if I'm having a problem playing a game on Saturday or something, I'll probably play it then. But this game has, I believe, six missions? Five. It has five. And that was the second one. So I got a week's worth, I guess, left of this game. So, yeah. I'm going to put this in my weekly gaming rotation. But anyway, thank you very much for watching. Thank you for being a part of it. Thank you for helping me. And I will see all of y'all, I believe, on Friday for Fancy Fucked Up Friday. I love you all. Have a good night if y'all are watching this at the nighttime. Have a good morning if you're watching this in the morning. Have a good evening if it is the daytime. And happy birthday to you if it is your birthday. And thank you very much for watching. And I will see all of y'all next time.